This week in Michigan football history.
This week we go back to November 6, 1937, as Michigan head football coach Harry Kipke was set to lead his Wolverines against a former huge rival, the Maroons of the University of Chicago. In 1937, our country was working its way out of the Great Depression, and the Wolverine Athletic Department was struggling to get the big house even a quarter full. It was also a dark time for both the Michigan and Chicago football programs, and a far cry from the dominance the team shared around the turn of the century. The pressure was building on Coach Kipke, an All-American player under Fielding Yost in the 1920s. He took the coaching reins in 1929 and had wild success in his first half decade. From 1930 to 1933, his Wolverines won four straight conference titles, including back-to-back national titles. After this remarkable start, things took a horrible turn in 1934, as team MVP Gerald Ford and crew mustered just a single win. Things didn't get much better in the seasons that followed for Kipke. Rumors of fake jobs and illegal practices persisted, and the Ann Arbor elite found his association with a jet named Harry Bennett distasteful. And maybe they had a point. Bennett was the right-hand man of auto tycoon Henry Ford, and also his enforcer, wolf, and cleaner. Things weren't going much better for the University of Chicago, whose football team was a mere shadow of itself back when Amos Alonzo Stagg's teams ruled the West. Stagg was forced to retire in 1932 as Chicago sought to de-emphasize athletics. Can you imagine? On this day in 1937, Kipke earned his final victory in front of the home fans, a 13-12 win over the Maroons, although just 23,000 bothered to show up. Michigan limped through the balance of the season, and in the end, Kipke was fired. Princeton's Fritz Kreisler was selected to lead the Wolverines over the next decade. Chicago toughed it out until 1939, when they folded the football team and left the Big Ten. On the bright side, the handoff to Kreisler went swimmingly, with Kipke's star recruit, Tom Harmon, and the new coach in his winged helmet got off to a great start. Kreisler's team consistently finished in the top 10 and capped off his remarkable career in 1947 in Pasadena with another Michigan National Championship. Go Blue! Beat the Hoosiers. For more, check out WTKA.com and MVictors.com for the Key Bank Countdown to Kickoff. This is Greg Dulick.